This one is...
لونين عشان ارتري وفين
يس ذس از فور ذا ارتري وفين ايوه
ذا
وش هذا الحين لمبر فليكسس
تذكره وش هو
لمبر فليكسس
لا هذا ما اذكره صدق ولا حضرت
كيلو فليب
ايه
عشان قلت خطيط استراتيجي
شوف صار منه عطل عطل يا ابوي صار
You know that this abdominal aorta is runs in the posterior on the posterior abdominal wall. Abdominal aorta begins at the level of lower border of 12 thoracic vertebra as the continuation of descending thoracic aorta. It ends at the level of lower border of L4 vertebra by dividing into right and left common iliac arteries. The branches of abdominal aorta you can divide in Anterior branches are unpaired.
Unpaired.
These are also called the ventral branches. Second is lateral branches. These are paired. And terminal branches.
Which is the common?
Right and left common iliac artery and median sacral small is coming here. Small artery. Median sacral.
Yes. Always present?
Always present, and sometimes it is considered as a dorsal branch. But mostly it is considered as a terminal branch. So the ventral branches, lateral branches are lumbar arteries, but the ventral branches are important. Ventral branches are 1, 2, 3. These are celiac trunk, superior, mesenteric, artery and inferior mesenteric artery. Celiac trunk is artery of foregut. And this is superior mesenteric is artery of midgut. And inferior mesenteric is artery of hindgut. It's very clear?
Very clear.
Celiac trunk, this first branch is celiac trunk. Celiac trunk divides into three. This is Yes, left gastric artery, splenic artery, and hepatic artery. Celiac trunk gives three. This is
splenic.
Splenic artery,
left
gastric artery, and
hepatic
artery. Splenic artery runs, you know, splenic artery goes towards the spleen. And supply the spleen. Splenic artery also gives a left gastroepiploic artery that runs along the greater curvature of the stomach and anastomosed with the right gastroepiploic artery. This left gastric artery, it goes toward the lesser curvature of stomach. Hepatic artery divides into right hepatic artery and left hepatic artery that enter in the porta hepatis of liver. But before dividing into right and left hepatic artery, hepatic artery gives one branch that is right gastric artery and gastroduodenal artery. This gastroduodenal artery divides into right gastroepiploic artery and right gastroepiploic artery and superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. Again. Ventral branches are celiac trunk, superior mesenteric and inferior mesenteric. Celiac trunk is artery of foregut plus spleen plus liver plus gallbladder. And superior mesenteric artery is artery of midgut. And inferior mesenteric artery is artery of hindgut. We take one by one. Superior mesenteric artery divides into three main branches. Left gastric artery, splenic artery and hepatic artery. Splenic artery goes toward the left side, supply the spleen. It gives the many small splenic branches and also it gives the branches to the pancreas. There are many branches to the pancreas. Okay. But one is arteria pancreatica magna, big branch. And also it gives the right and also it gives the short gastric arteries which supply the fundus of stomach. Also gives the left gastroepiploic artery. Left gastric artery supply to the stomach. Hepatic artery divides into right and left hepatic artery to supply the stomach, and also it gives the right gastric artery and gastroduodenal artery, and gastroduodenal artery divides into right gastroepiploic artery and superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. So these are the branches of celiac trunk supply the foregut and spleen and liver and gallbladder. It also gives cystic artery that supply the gallbladder. Usually right hepatic artery gives the cystic artery or the main. Branches of superior mesenteric artery are branches to the midgut, that is inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery, the jejunal branches, the ileal branches, ileocolic artery and right colic artery and midcolic artery. These supply the midgut. And branches are inferior mesenteric artery, these are left colic artery, sigmoidal artery and superior rectal artery. Khalas. So these are branches of abdominal aorta. Very easy?
Very.
Again, parental branches, celiac trunk, superior mesenteric, inferior mesenteric. Celiac trunk, three branches. Gastric, left gastric artery, splenic artery, hepatic artery. Hepatic artery,
gallbladder.
Hepatic artery supply the gallbladder and liver. And also it gives the right gastric artery and gastroduodenal artery, which divides into right gastroepiploic artery and superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. Okay. The branches of superior mesenteric artery are inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery and jejunal branches and ileal branches and ileocolic artery and right colic artery and midcolic artery. Okay. And the branches of inferior mesenteric artery, left colic artery, sigmoidal artery and superior rectal artery. Khalas? So these are branches.
A lot of branches. A lot.
Pelvic is not involved. Pelvic. The ileus.
Iliac artery, you know, this terminal branches right and left iliac artery and median sacral artery. The iliac artery here is iliac artery is small artery, short course. And it divides in external iliac and internal iliac artery. External artery becomes the femoral artery. Internal iliac artery divides into anterior posterior branches that supply all the structures, organs in the pelvis.
Ah,
internal.
Internal.
To the uterus, to the bladder, to the rectum, to the ovary, to the... Any questions?
Thank you very much.
You know about the inferior vena cava, you know?
Now what is about that?
About those ileus being
given. Yeah. That's...
If you make it also.
Okay, tomorrow, inshallah, we'll be at 11, inshallah.
Thank you.